Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over some different options for sheet protection in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
Here I have a spreadsheet in Excel, and I would like to show you a few different reasons why you may want to use sheet protection. The first one could be that you just don't really want anyone else looking at the data that's on your sheet. So that would be more for data security. But another reason you may want to protect your sheet is, if I click down here, I can see up here that I have a formula. And if I'm using this sheet with many people, it's very possible that I click into this cell and just start typing away, and boom, my formula is gone. So sometimes people like to use sheet protection so that their formulas stay intact. So Excel automatically locks all cells in a worksheet so that when you go to protect them, every single cell in the sheet will be protected. So if I go over here to review, I can just click Protect Sheet. And by default, Excel protects the locked and unlocked cells. And up here, I can put a password in if I would like to, but let's just say I don't put a password in for now, and I say okay. So now if I click anywhere in my sheet and start typing, I'm going to get an error saying that this is a protected sheet. However, if I look at my blue cells here and down here, these are cells that I actually want the user to be able to change. So while I want to protect these formulas over here, sometimes I want the user to be able to type values in here. So how do I go about fixing that?
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Well, first I'm going to click unprotect the sheet because it is protected. And then I'm going to highlight these three cells by keeping my left mouse button down and dragging down here. And then I'm going to hold down the control button on my keyboard, click in B12, and also drag all the way down here. And that way I have selected all the cells where I want data entry. Now if I right click and go to Format Cells, there's this tab over here called Protection. And I can see that that is being locked. But I would like to unlock this for our little demo today. So I'm going to uncheck locked and then say okay. So remember, I haven't protected the sheet again. So if I type in here, I will type over that text. I'm just going to hit escape because I don't want to save that. But if I type over here where there is a formula, I'm also going to be able to put text in there. So again, I'll hit escape and get out of there. But now if I go to protect sheet, I'm not going to put a password in for now. I'm going to say okay. Now I can click on this blue one and go to 20,000 and hit enter. And my data will change. But if I go over here where there's a formula and I try to type, I'll get that error message saying that this is a protected sheet. So this is a two-step process if you want to have some cells that are not protected. First, you make sure you unprotect your sheet, and then highlight the cells that you don't want to protect. Right-click, go to Format Cells, and then you can check this box or uncheck the box for locked right here, and then say OK. And don't forget, after you're done making all your changes, you want to hit the Protect Sheet again, so that your data goes back to being protected. So let's do that right now. So if I hit Protect Sheet, this time let's put in a password. I'm just going to put I love Excel as my password and say okay. And I will be prompted to put the password in again just so that I don't mistype it. So again, I'm gonna write I love Excel and say okay. So now if you hand this to a user and they try to come in here, again, you won't be able to, but if I go over here in the cells that I am allowing them to enter data in, they will be able to enter info into that cell. But if I go up here to unprotect sheet, now I have to know the password. So I'm just going to type I love Excel and say okay, and then my sheet will be unlocked. So another thing I can do is I can protect the entire workbook. If I click on this button that says Protect Workbook, I can put in a password if I would like to, but I'm really protecting my workbook just for the structure. So let's not put in a password and just say okay. So what does protecting the structure mean? Well, it means various different things that apply to your Excel file at the workbook level. And one example is down here. If I hit this plus button, I can't really add a new sheet. So there's going to be certain things that are done at the workbook level that you will not be able to do if your workbook is protected. So if this is grayed out and you are actually working with a workbook that doesn't allow you to add another sheet, you can always go over here to review. And if this button is pushed down, that means the workbook is protected. So if I click on that, I've unprotected the workbook, and now I can come down to this plus and I can add a new sheet. If you ever get locked out of an Excel sheet and the previous developer has put in a password that you don't know, we've actually created a video on how to get around the workbook password and the worksheet password. So I will include a link to that video in the description below on YouTube. We also go through the process of protecting your worksheet and workbook on our blog, and I'll include a link to that as well. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.